Hello everyone, welcome to another edition of Horizon Insider. We are back with the Blade 230S V2. Reason being is a lot of guys have been buying this as their first collective pitch helicopter. Same with me. And I started thinking that, you know, if you haven't really flown a lot of maybe drones or fixed pitch helis, it's probably a good idea to give you a quick crash course on how to fly one of these. Now, assuming you've set it up in your radio or bought the ready-to-fly version, everything in your radio should be correct. So we're going to run through things to kind of look for on your screen and then kind of show you some tips and tricks on how to fly these guys. All right, so the first thing I want to point out here is that with collective pitch helicopters, you essentially have normally three different flight modes. Essentially, the first one, which is what we're in right now, is normal mode. This is essentially going to make the helicopter fly equivalent to how a drone or a fixed pitch heli would fly. Now, this helicopter does come with some safe stability, but that's beside the point. So, let me bump that light back on. You're going to notice with the throttle, I have negative 100. As I go up, goes right up to positive 100, or 99. There we go. So, that's controlling total throttle right there. Your pitch is only going to change a little bit, and that's essentially just used to get you off the ground. Nothing's crazy going on here. Where it gets really fun is when you actually turn into your idle one mode, which for me is on flight, the switch B. Now, if you look, my throttle, no matter what I do, is fixed at 70% throttle no matter what. Now, all we're changing is the pitch. And as you'll see, let me turn the light back on. You're going to get negative 100, positive 100 with the pitch. So now your essentially RPM of your motor is the same, 70% throttle, and you're only controlling the blade. This is how you get into doing 3D, inverted flight, things of that nature. You also have idle 2, which kicks your throttle all the way up to 100% and also still has full pitch. So that's the first thing I want to really talk to you guys about, is that you can start flying in normal mode, learn the basics of flying around hovering without having to worry too much about the pitch, and then kick up the idle from there. So now another thing, if you programmed your transmitter correctly, you should have a throttle cut. So make sure whenever you go to plug in your battery, you have a throttle cut on. And for me, that's always switch H, so I'm going to go ahead and flick that off. You hear it go to normal mode instead of... That way you know you're ready to fly. So right now, treat this as live. Realistically, if the battery's plugged in, you should treat it as a live helicopter regardless. And you can always do a control check where you actually look at the swash plate moving. It's very hard to see. I don't know if the camera's gonna be able to zoom in enough. You might wanna just make sure that that is correct before each flight. It's another good safety precaution. You really can't check the rudder until you take off. But essentially we're ready to fly right now. So I'm going to start out by flying in the normal mode and show you how this essentially is going to fly just like a fixed pitch heli. Then we're going to bump it into that low idle mode, which is that 70% throttle, and I'm going to show you kind of the difference in how I use the sticks. So let's go ahead and spool this up. It's really not going to take off from the ground until you're right about half throttle. Or higher, actually. So as you see right now, I'm totally controlling the helicopter just with the actual motor speed. You're not really changing the pitch all that much. You can hear the motor pulsing there. This is a great way to kind of just learn basic maneuvers. Keep your tail in towards you, that way your controls match what the heli's doing. And just get comfortable, honestly, just doing what I'm doing right now. We're fighting a little bit of wind here around the side of a hangar. But just practice this. Get familiar with how the helicopter reacts. Kind of do a couple little rudder bumps there, see how it behaves, and just take your time. Maybe fly a whole battery like this. You could even spin around if you want, but this is the best way to just get comfortable knowing what the helicopter is actually going to do. You can practice doing some circles and stuff, but really, in my opinion, get good at this first. I'm going to go ahead and land here. Get good at doing that first. By the way, when you land, you can go ahead and flick your throttle cut right away. You don't have to worry about spooling down your throttle. So now we're gonna take off and you're gonna hear me bump it into the idle one. I don't know what this is actually gonna call it. Let's hear it. Oh, it's not gonna do it because I'm on hold mode. You're gonna see me actually take off, bump that up, and you're gonna see the helicopter, the motor's gonna sound identical the whole flight. You're just gonna hear the blades changing, but that's essentially all that's happening. So let's go ahead and take off. Always start in that normal mode. Do not flick it in the throttle mode right now. Throttle mode. Do not flick this into that high idle mode right now. Otherwise, as soon as you take this off, it's going to try to spin up. All right, now, right now, I'm gonna go ahead and flip. So you see the RPMs come up a little. Now all that this does is control the pitch. So as you can see, it's much more responsive. So essentially when the stick is centered, your blades are flat, give or take. There's some pitch built in a little bit. This is how you're gonna start learning 3D stuff. And realistically, I would recommend if you're ready to go inverted, go ahead and flip into the higher idle like that. As you can see, the motor's much happier. Get it, bring it a little closer here. It's much more responsive. This is really what you need to be practicing your 3D stuff in. And in my opinion, don't be afraid to crash. That's one thing. As long as you're far enough out to where you're not in danger, don't be afraid to learn. Don't be afraid to get this close to the ground. Practice by doing some circles. This is going to be a lot of rudder stick. You don't need very much of your, what we would call ailerons in a plane. Just practice doing nice little figure eights. If you ever get uncomfortable, try to get the tail back towards you. That way it matches up with what you're doing on the sticks. Spin around a little bit. As you see, it spins faster in this mode too. Let me come back a little bit. And really, once you're comfortable with this, you're in really good shape, because then you have the basics muscle memory required for when, if you flip it over, what you need to do. So all they did right there, you initiate a flip, and then you actually go negative collective. So I'm gonna show you that same maneuver here. And essentially that's how you compensate for the heli being upside down, is the blades are actually negative collective. Let me bring this back in, we'll talk a little bit more. So again, I'm gonna show you how when I land, I'm just gonna go ahead and hit the throttle cut right away. Totally fine, there's nothing wrong with that. Just make sure you flip that back to your normal mode before you fly again. Your radio will yell at you if you don't, but it's a good tip. These can be dangerous for obvious reasons, so just keep that in mind when you're flying. So again, if you have questions, let us know. If you're new to the 230S or even like the 150S, spare parts I'd recommend is the main gear. This is pretty much, I shouldn't say always gonna strip, but you gotta think that motor's spinning really high RPM. If your blade hits the ground and stops, something's gotta give. There's a reason this is plastic, let's put it that way. I would carry some main booms. You can bend these back into place if needed. I know from personal experience. Maybe a landing gear, and then a lot of the links up here, they're cheap. It's a good thing to have in your bag. And then I'd say blades, but these are the original blades I've had. So I wouldn't recommend having blades, honestly. Main gear is the big one. And yeah, just take it slow. And like I said, do not be afraid to crash. Obviously, don't be silly. Stay away from yourself. Be mindful of other people that might be at the flying field or private property. We're blessed with this nice, huge open space we can kind of practice with. But don't be afraid to crash. There's a reason we sell parts. These are cake to fix. They look complicated. These are cake to fix. So we're going to let you guys go. Hopefully this helped you out. We'll see you next time in the next edition of Horizon Insider.